John Lynch will have his eye on Brett Favre and on Donald Driver, the longtime Packer receiver. If you look at Donald Driver's fingers, if he holds his hands like this, you'll see some gnarled, crooked, bent digits. Almost all of Driver's fingers at some point in time have either been broken or dislocated by catching some lightning-fast spirals from Brett Favre. Hardships of a 9-year job, one where he has quietly caught at least one pass in 86 straight games. But nobody knows about it, because Driver's not the kind of guy to beat on his chest and yell, "Look at me." And why would he? Because at the end of the day, hardships have very little to do with broken fingers. For Donald Driver, hardships tells a story about how he got here.
This is Donald Driver, and this is my story. This is my trials and my journey to my life as I know it. People go through hard times, you know, no one can control that. There's nothing out there today that can hurt me worse than what I went through when I was a kid. You know, the things that we went through, living in U-Haul truck, in and out of hotels, you know, living with friends. I know how it feels to not have lights, not have gas, not have water, not have food in your mouth. I know how that feels. I know how it feels to, you know, to lay on the street. I know how that feels. Those nights and those days, you know, they're more like hell. I never want to live that life again.
Dad was in and out of prison. When I was born, my dad wasn't even there. He tried to raise 17 beautiful kids, but he couldn't do it all.
Driver's escape was athletics, which earned him a scholarship to Alcorn State University. After a stellar college career, he anxiously awaited the NFL draft.
So many teams called that day, saying, you know, we like you, we're gonna draft you this round or that round. And first round went by, second round goes by, like sixth round go by, you see all these receivers are getting taken. And in my eyes, I'm better than them. But to the scouts, I must not be. And then the phone rings. And my dad comes running out, screaming, "Quick, hey! Quick!" I'm going, "Yes, Dad, what?" "Green Bay Packers on the phone." I looked at my family and said, "We're gonna be okay."
That you were in a lifestyle of seeing people, drug dealers driving these really fancy cars, and you wanted that too.
Exactly. I mean, you as a kid, that's all you see, that's all you want. And people always ask, so how do you get out of it?
Right.
You know, I always tell kids is that how you want to be remembered at the end of the day. That's what it's all about, how you want to be remembered. I didn't want to be remembered as a kid that everyone looked at and said, oh, this kid was bad. You know, I wanted someone to say, every time I look at this person, I look at how his ups and downs have made him successful.
Tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. true underdog, ultimate success story, 14 years old? That was the question that I asked during the press conference, was sitting in a bedroom in Houston, Texas. His family obviously didn't have a lot of money, and basically he was talking to his brother Marvin and said, you know what, I'm gonna make something out of myself one of these days, and I'm gonna make it out of here. And definitely Donald Driver did at 38 years of age.
Well, I mean, I grew up homeless, you know, I lived in and out of U-Haul trucks. You know, when mom's trying to raise five kids, it's very hard. But, you know, I think one thing she's always said is that God's gonna get us out of it.
Well, it is, of course, Donald Driver Day here on today's TMJ4. As we said, the small guy from a small school wasn't even supposed to be with the Green Bay Packers in 1999.
But Donald Driver leaves as the team's all-time leader in yards and receptions, and we are celebrating.